Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here. So in today's video, I'm going to be doing my Todoist setup video. This is the July 2018 version. So I've been doing setup videos for about 3 years now, which is mad. So hopefully I can add this to the setup tour video. So maybe you can see my progression and how I've gone through things. Now I have a sort of something to admit before I start this video. I am wearing a Trello t-shirt whilst doing a Todoist setup video, which I feel super weird about, the fact that it's on while I'm doing this, but it really doesn't matter, does it? I've worn the Trello t-shirt before during features, and hopefully it hasn't been too bad. So today I wanted to dive through what my Todoist looks like now. For those who don't know, I moved to Things 3 for about 3 months at the start of the year. So things definitely changed and adapted, but it's something that I've obviously moved back to Todoist now. I wanted to say that I did make my title of my video a couple of weeks ago a bit clickbaity, goodbye Todoist, but I just wanted to explain my sort of process there. And also get through a hard point of the fact that you don't necessarily need to switch to Todoist applications all the time, but hopefully it didn't offend anyone. So I've got my notes here. I just wanted to make sure I'm covering all of the points because this has been my biggest change in my Todoist account since I started. I do say that every time, but this actually almost reset me, completely reset me as a Todoist user. And I think it's definitely been beneficial in my productivity and has really helped me. So let's dive in. So the things that I really particularly want to talk about straight away is the inbox, my projects areas, and also an additional project area that I've got, as well as labels use. So let's start with the inbox. Now I've got a few things in here already, just dumping stuff in there. But as you can imagine, the inbox is a vital area for many people. Now previously I didn't use inbox as much, but now I am filling the inbox up dramatically to round about 40 to 50 new items a day. So the Todoist inbox is getting used a lot more for me. As you can imagine, the experience, obviously ideas come to me during the day, but I'm using the Todoist inbox as more of an outlet to put that there. So the way that I sort of go around doing that, that's everything from articles to links to, you know, things I actually have to do, maybe defer to later, is I will stop during the day and plot out some of those items. So I want to talk a bit more about that in the workflow side of stuff, which we'll go into a bit more detail in a minute. Just a note, if you want to skip ahead or do anything else, you can use the timestamps below. But yeah, the inbox has been a place where I've been dumping a lot more links, all those items as I go across my day. So I will have relatively near the end of the day around 40 to 50 of them. Today's actually been super weak. I'm on 17, but I actually did a refresh earlier anyway. So the inbox has been more of a predominant area for me. And as you can imagine, that's actually affected my karma score a lot. So what I was previously doing a lot in Things 3, because they don't have a karma ranking and the deletion function, I couldn't really be asked with it on the web version, is I was ticking off a load of items to get rid of them, not necessarily because I completed them, but because I was trying to get rid of them. And that's what I'm doing here now, and it's actually a really bad habit. The only reason I should be doing it like that is because when you select stuff in Todoist, you have to go up here to go and delete them. And then once you delete them, you have to go to a secondary screen, which seems really long-winded. Maybe there is a keyboard shortcut. Maybe it's just delete, but it doesn't seem to have worked. But as you can imagine, that is a bit long-winded. So just ticking stuff off seems a lot simpler to do. Maybe there is a keyboard shortcut, but again, that's affecting my karma, which I'll mention nearer the end. So probably the biggest area change for me is projects. For those who don't know, I used to have a project area for everything. But during the last maybe year or so, I really fine-tuned it. So I had like a lot less projects, a lot less areas to contend with, mainly because I wanted to minimize. And as you can imagine, I wanted to reduce it. So now I have three core projects. One is called personal, one is called freelance, and the final one is called Nest. Now, personal is essentially all of my personal items. So this could be home, family life, a vacation, activities, stuff that doesn't necessarily fall into the freelance category, although a lot of things merge. And freelance. Freelance encapsulates everything that I do towards my projects and activities. So as you can see, I don't and no longer have projects per client or per area. And this has actually reduced my stress level a lot. Now, I previously had to organize everything into the project areas, and maybe I'm underutilizing this, but when I go now to, for example, today, and this is a bad example, I can go, let me just see the next day, I can see visually really easy. So for example, red, okay, I've got a personal item in there, wedged between all of these freelance items. So as you can imagine, it's a nice way for me visually seeing stuff. And for me, I actually correlate red to personal and blue to freelance, which is more about my brand. So as you can imagine, that was a huge revelation for me. And as you can see, it's really slimmed down that section. So at any given time over the last couple of months, I've really not had more than 60 tasks in freelance at any given point, and they're the ones I plotted far ahead as well. And in personal, I round about have 20 in that project. So as you can see, I've really limited and cut down the amount of tasks I'm using. So I'm really only looking between 15 to 30 days ahead with the task manager. So you're probably wondering, what the hell is this final area called Nest? Now, I've labeled it yellow, but Nest is a really undisclosed area for me right now. It's more of just a notes area. So it's more almost like a someday maybe to some extent. I'm just dumping stuff in there. It was full the other day. I'm just dumping stuff in there that I don't really find useful right now or don't deserve to go in the inbox, but something that I will routinely check. So for example, I will routinely check this at the end of the week, make sure I don't have anything there, but it's for these things that I need to put in there for later, if that makes sense. So what I would recommend is not taking this advice just yet, because for me, I'm just working out how I'm using this. So you know, give me a bit of time to work out what that was. I used to have an area that I used to dump stuff in, but of course, that's obviously adapted. So you're probably wondering, Francesco, how are you using labels? Because you used a lot of labels before. I'm not using labels at all. Labels were a way for me to bulk out tasks. As you can see here, now it's a lot more streamlined. There's no necessary labels underneath them. And the reason I'm doing this is because, as you can see by my projects area, I've obviously reset. I've gone back to personal, freelance, kept it simple. And what I want to do at the moment is make sure that I'm fully confident on my workflow before I move forward with my use of labels. I want to make sure that I am optimizing my use of labels to the maximum. So what I will be doing in the next month or so is sitting around with myself and going, how can I reduce my time by using labels? How can I save time by using labels? And how can I reduce the amount of them when I'm using them? And then I can set up filters from there. So as you can imagine, it's something that I'm gonna be taking a bit of time out on. It's definitely something I will be using in the future, but it's just something that doesn't really compute right now for this process. So as you can imagine, you know, this has changed. The projects and labels area has been the biggest change. And the sort of workflow side of stuff, so this is the sort of day-to-day side of stuff, I have between 5 and 8 main tasks in my inbox during the day. I'm using priorities a lot more, not based on energy levels. So previously what I did was, for example, this could be high energy tasks, ones that took more of my energy out. And of course they do in this case, but what I'm doing is I'm actually assigning them based on priority, because I think that's the way my work has changed a lot, and Things3 helped me to work that out. Things3 didn't actually have priorities, so it made it a lot more difficult to define what exactly was the most important thing for the day, apart from obviously the deadline function and things like that, but this is actually more of a visual function for me. So you can see here that I'm using it a lot more efficiently. Particularly love this feature, and it's definitely helped me in the last couple of months. So the way that I sort of go about my day with Todoist now is I have the day, so I have the morning. The morning I'll wake up and my Todoist will be pretty much laid out for me. Round about 10, up to 10 tasks, not really any more than that, will be laid out ready. And that's from morning tasks, so I'll use a morning task to list. So for example, let me just demonstrate. For example, tomorrow morning, I'm traveling most of the day, but I would have something like this, like an admin tasks to start my day, because it's a light, it's full of different tasks in the comments, so I'll use the comments to fill that up, and basically just small wins that I can start my day with, and that's how I will start my day. Now, when I get to about lunchtime, which is around about 12 to 2 p.m., dependent on the day, really, I will then go, okay, I need to reschedule my afternoon. This is how my sort of productivity has changed, I would say. I have become a morning sort of person in terms of getting that majority of stuff done. But then priorities shift, things come into my inbox, things come to the, in, you know, all of this stuff comes in. You know, ideas happen. Like, I will think of an idea for a video, or someone will go, you need to do a bit of work now that is based on this. So what I'll do is around about, let's say 12:30, for example, I'll go, okay, let me grab a bit of time on my Todoist. I will sit there and replot out my full afternoon. Now, this won't take really that long, 5-10 minutes. And essentially from here, I have the rest of the afternoon planned out. I can then go home or wherever I'm going in the afternoon, and then just finish the rest of the tasks that are laid out in front of me. And this has actually saved me a lot of time. Previously, when I was doing it before, it's actually something that I really wasn't thinking was too much of a problem. So for example, when I was doing it before, I was literally plotting out my full day. By the end of the day, I was like maybe losing out on 3 or 4 tasks because I was deferring them to the next day. But since I've been doing this, I've actually been very much more efficient in defining what my priorities are, as well as seeing the short-term and long-term benefits of certain tasks. So that's sort of how my sort of structure's changed. It's almost a refresh, but it's definitely really helped. So in terms of the next 7 days, obviously this has been a very helpful area for me. You can see the numbers much lower, and that's because I've been more rigor in my structure in terms of not overpopulating it. But now I sort of plan, I guess, 2 to 3 days in advance, not much longer, if I'm honest. Obviously, what I'll do on a Thursday night is I'll sit down with my Notion account, I'll look at my goals, and I'll plot the bulk tasks into Todoist. So I'll go on to Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday of the week after, and go do 3 things maybe per day that are high priority, which will help me work towards my goals, right? And that is a very beneficial system for me. That is like, I love doing that actually, because it helps to define what I need to do those days. So that's great. But what I'll then do is the evenings of those items. So for example, let's say it was Monday evening, or let's take today, for example, Tuesday evening, if I want holiday tomorrow. Tuesday evening, I would then plot out my tasks for the next day. And of course, when I woke up in the morning, I do them there. And then what between 12 and 2 p.m. that day, I would then refresh them for the afternoon. But that check-in, that 5-minute check-in, that plotting out of the day really does help. I try and do that 2 days in advance. So what I'll do is, for example, on a Sunday night, I will plot 2 days in advance and have a general structure, and then I can just tweak things, because obviously things change based on energy levels and things like that. So you can see that I'm not really planning too far in advance with this experience. I'm not mapping out too much, but this sort of process is actually really helping me at the moment. I wake up and I don't have to focus on planning, I focus on doing. Midday, I plan, back to it, and then in the evening, I plan. So it's like plan, do. I don't know whether that's a thing. Maybe it's just me. So what I do as well at the start of every week is I use a new theme. And this is actually really just an aesthetic thing. So I'll go onto settings and I'll change my theme at the end of the week. And this actually helps with defining a clear distance between the week before. And it will help me remove any negatives to some extent. So for example, let's say I had like a really unproductive week. Like Thursday night, what I'll do is I'll go, I'm changing the theme to this one. And what happens is I get this new clean look of the thing. And I guess you can, you know, feel like you're refreshing to some extent. This is a really stupid concept, but it does help. And sometimes if I'm feeling super in the mood, I'll go to change desktop background on Mac. And I'll go to solid colors, custom colors press this icon here and select the background color. And as you can see, the whole experience, and I've done this before, I've shown you guys before, whole experience blocks out and you can see a really clean looking Todoist account. So that's really good. That's something that I use quite regularly if I'm in a focused zone, and that becomes very useful. So additions, some of the additions that I've had is my use of the comments. I was using subtasks a lot before, no longer, just use comments. You can pretty much see for the majority of tasks on this list, you can see that I've got comments in there. A lot of them have links, a lot of them have checklists in there. I don't use the subtask function because it gets too messy. Even when you click into project, I don't want to have to go into my project at the moment for freelance. I just want to see it all in one comment system. So the comments are beautiful. Obviously, I didn't like them in Things 3 in terms of notes, but I liked subtasks, so this is just an extension of that. Now, you're probably wondering, Francesco, you know, during the period of time when you use Things 3, your karma must have been... It was, which really didn't help. But obviously I'm back now, so that's obviously ramped up. But as you can see, my karma has not really improved. Obviously, as I always state, I don't really use karma. It's more of just a guideline, I guess, and just me seeing. I use view completed tasks more than I do karma whatsoever. So you can see here, I've completed 65 out of 14 tasks. And that's a combination of me clearing my inbox, Todoist inbox, and also a combination of me doing my, I think it was 1 p.m. today, my review of the day for the afternoon. I was clearing out certain items there. So you can see it's over, since I've been moved back, it's over populated per day. So that's something that I wouldn't really go off. Maybe I need to change it based on that experience. But again, I feel like that's dead data because I'm just clearing stuff that doesn't necessarily exist. So maybe that's just a functional thing for me. You can see weekly that's changed a lot. So you see that it's gone up from like what it was before, like 200 to 413. And that's still me only fixing only up to 8 to 10 tasks on there at a time. But yeah, my karma has gone up. As you can imagine, it was dramatically lower before. And my streak, I lost my streak as well. I think I put it on vacation mode, but I actually lost my streak last year. Oh, I lost my streak last year. I don't know why I'm talking about that. But I did lose another streak of like one, maybe 200 or something like this. Doesn't really matter. That's my approach to it. So in terms of next steps, the next steps I'm doing is I'm going to be evaluating my labels usage. I'm going to be very strict about it. I'm going to be looking at my filters, playing around with which ones I can use the most. Once I've got my label set up, I'm going to be looking at Zapier and Workflow to reduce complexity in my Todoist account. And finally, I'm going to be looking at Toggle, which is a time tracking resource that will help me to manage how much time I'm spending on certain tasks. So guys, that was a review of my Todoist account. As you can imagine, let me know in the comments if you have any questions about everything. But as you can imagine, it's changed dramatically, thinned out. You're probably going, ah, Francesco, it's horrible now. You had a beautiful setup, but this is actually really gorgeous. The final thing that I had was that I occasionally use emoji on personal items, really small use. So for example, if it just brightens up certain personal items. But apart from that, that's really all that's changed. Anyway, guys, hopefully you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments below. Hit the like button if you enjoyed it. If you're a brand new subscriber here, hit subscribe as well. And that's all of the pitches. I really love to hear from you in the comments how you're using Todoist. But as you can imagine, welcome to Keep Productive Community if you're new. And I'll see you guys very, very soon. Thanks very much, guys. Make sure to have a great week. Keep productive. And I'll see you guys very soon.